Baron Brown, and I'm a junior doctor in Leeds. I'm here today representing the British Medical Association, the voice of UK doctors, and we are calling for the public to have a final say on the Brexit deal. Two years ago, we were told that Brexit would enrich and improve our health service. They literally wrote it on a bus, and many of us believed them. But now, the narrative around Brexit is one of damage control. Hearing our health secretary talk about stockpiling essential medicines should terrify and infuriate everyone, whether they voted leave or remain. Losing our highly skilled European NHS staff at a time when we are already overstretched is unacceptable. A Brexit at any cost is not a price that our NHS can afford. And it's a price that will ultimately be paid for by those who staff our health service and the patients that we care for. I am one of those patients. I'm a patient who frequently relies on the NHS and its staff from around the world. We have a publicly funded health service providing first-rate care free at the point of need. The NHS is one of the greatest things this country has ever achieved, and yet over the past 2 years, thank you! And yet over the past 2 years, it's become clear that Brexit is a threat to both the NHS and the nation's health. We all need the NHS. So it's only right that we, the ordinary people of this country, have the final say. Because whether we face a good deal, a bad deal, or no deal, our exit from the EU is not a done deal.
Yeah.
So let's give the people a final say. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Hannah. Okay, small quiz, very quick. What do these companies have in common? Asda, AstraZeneca, Jaguar Land Rover, Airbus, Nissan, Ryanair, Superdry. All warn of the potential catastrophe to their business and to business more generally that Brexit represents. How would Brexit go down if presented to the judges of the Dragon's Den? We have an answer for you. Let's ask Deborah Meaden.
I knew she'd be here.
I'm guessing you might know the answer to that. Hello, London. Hello to all those people who made a massive journey to be here. I was with some of you this morning. And hello to the rest of the United Kingdom. So I've worked in business all of my life. If there's one thing business doesn't like, it's uncertainty. 2 years ago, we had no idea what chaos Brexit was going to bring, and today we know even less. This causes business to pause. When business doesn't invest, it means fewer jobs. Less tax revenue means less money to spend on our public services. If someone came to me with a proposal that said, I will make you and your family poorer. I will hurt businesses, jobs and communities across the UK, and I will actively cut off ties to our largest trading partner. And if we don't get a deal, then we're going to have to stockpile food and medicine. I'm guessing you know what I'd say. I'm out. So how does stopping a teenager who never enjoyed school or working for anybody from starting their own business in ceramics in Italy? Because that's my story, but it's not uniquely my own, far from it. Thousands of young people, a whole generation born in the EU, from whom the sky used to be the limit, now facing barriers I never had to face when I set up my first business. And in addition to that, feeling the loss of their wider citizenship. But we have shown here today that that's not the future we want for our businesses, for our families, for our communities. So when you leave here, go back and talk to your communities, talk to the people you walk with, and wake them up to this, because together we can win a people's vote.
Yes!
Deborah Meaden! Woo! Yay. We demand
a people's vote, Mariella. I was just...